Hello students, welcome back to our session. In this session we are going to discuss various devices that facilitate a network, or devices which we are going to use while we are having a network. Okay, so from your understanding, what would be the devices to are used in networking? So there will obviously there will be modem, and then there will be other devices such as a switch, a hub, gateway, then different connectors like RJ45 connectors, then different networking cards like NIC or network interface card, then routers will be there, Ethernet will be there, bridge will be there, repeaters will be there. So etc. will be the different networking devices that are used in a networking section. Okay, so we are going to see each one in detail. Okay, so the first one we are going to see is a modem. Okay, so a modem is a device that allows us to connect and communicate with other computers via telephone lines. Okay, so a modem performs two operations, a modulation and a demodulation. Modulation means a modem changes the digital data from your computer into analog data, a format that can be carried over by telephone lines or other cables that are used in networking. Okay, so modulation means converting the digital information in your computer system into signals that are analog. Okay, then second operation is demodulation, converting this analog information that is coming into your computer system and then to digital data. Okay, digital data means digital information in your computer system. So a analog signal coming into your computer system via cables or anything, that has to be converted into digital information into your computer system. Okay, so that is demodulation process. Okay, so that is what a modem is. Okay, so it modem means modulation and demodulation. Two operations are performed there, modulation and demodulation. Okay, converting digital data into analog data and analog data back to digital data. So that is modem. And then the shift of digital data into analog data and converting it back again allows two computers to speak with one another. Okay, so that is what a modem is. Okay, which helps us to communicate with the other computers through telephone lines. Okay, next one we are going to see is an RJ45 connector. An RJ45 is short for registered junk 45. It's an 8-wire connector which is commonly used to connect computers on the local area network such as LAN. Okay, so usually it works in with the twisted pair cables. Okay, so that is what an RJ45 connector is. Next one we are going to see is network interface card and Ethernet. Okay, so any computer which has to be connected to the network must have a network interface card installed on that particular computer. Then only it can be able to connect to a network. Okay, so a computer communicates with other computers on a network with the help of an network interface card only. Okay, so it is designed to allow computers to communicate over a computer network. Okay, so it allows the users to connect each other either by using cables or wirelessly. It can perform this connection. It can establish this connection using either wired method or wireless method. Okay, so an NIC or network interface card with the works with the MAC address. Okay, so with the help of MAC address, it will uniquely identify each computer. Okay, it provides physical access to a networking medium. Okay, so it allows to get a physical access. That means a connection, a physical connection to the network. Then allows the users to connect to each other either by cables or wirelessly. That we have already said. That is the purpose of the Ethernet cables or Ethernet card or network interface card. Okay, next one we are going to see is a hub. So what is a hub? Okay, so a hub contains multiple ports. Okay, a hub is a device which contains multiple ports. When a packet arrives, okay, it is most used in packet switching technology. We are already discussed about different switching terminologies. Okay, so we have discussed one switching technology which is packet switching. Data is divided into packets and sent over the network. A hub is used in the case of packet switching. Okay, so when a packet arrives at one port, it is copied to all the ports in the hub. When the packets are copied, the destination address in the frame does not change to a broadcast address. It does it in a rudimentary way. It simply copies the data to all the nodes connected to the hub. Okay, so connect, it connects multiple computers to form a local area network. Okay, then the disadvantage and advantage at the same time is signal entered in the port will be transmitted to all other ports. Okay, so a packet has to find its own way to reach the destination. So a hub is a device that having multiple ports and connecting multiple computers to form a local area network. Okay, so that's what a hub is. Next we are going to see about a switch. Okay, or switching hub. A switch or switching hub is an intelligent hub that connects several nodes to form a network and redirects the received information only to the intended node. Okay, so a hub receives the information and sends it to the nodes that all the nodes are connected to that particular hub. Okay, but a switch sends the data only to the intended hub or device. Okay, so a switch works in the form of filter and forward data. Okay, a switch is an intelligent hub. It looks exactly like a hub and has the same function to connect multiple computers or devices in a network. But the difference is that it retransmits the received information only to the intended node. That's what a switch is. Okay, so next we are going to see is a repeater. So what is a repeater is? Okay, so a signal becomes weak after a short distance of communication. Okay, so that means when a signal is transferred through a cable or any other kind of media, a signal becomes weak after transmitting a distance. Okay, so a repeater is a device that regenerates the received signals and retransmit it to the destination. Okay, so since the signal becomes weak after a certain distance and cannot reach its destination, so the regeneration or amplification of signals are required. Okay, in that case, repeater is used. A device that receives the signal and retransmits it at a higher level or higher power. Okay, when a repeater receives a signal, it amplifies the signals and sent to the destination again. Okay, then the distance where the repeater is in a network or the distance between a repeater and a nodes, repeater and nodes is depends on the data transfer range. If the data need to be transferred in a long range, then number of repeaters may vary. Next device we are going to see is a router. Okay, routers are networking device that forwards data packets between network using headers and forwarding tables to determine the best path to forward the packets. Okay, it works on IP address to connect multiple networks like LANs or LANs. Okay, it helps us to choose the shortest path for the packets. Okay, so routers work at the network layer. Okay, or the of the TCP/IP model, and then routers also provide interconnectivity between like and unlike media. Okay, so different media. Routers also provide interconnectivity between different media. Okay, for example, transmitting from a wired medium to a wireless medium. Okay, so in that case, routers are also provide interconnectivity. A router is connected to at least two networks, commonly two LANs or two WANs, or a LAN and its ISP network. ISP means Internet Service Provider. So which one? The LAN and a service provider's network. Okay, so router is a device that works on the IP address to connect multiple networks like LANs or LANs. Next device we are going to see is a gateway. So what is a gateway? Okay, so a gateway is a network device that connects dissimilar networks. It established an intelligent connection between local area network and extra network with the completely different structures. Okay, in a network, different type of networks are there. So, for example, LAN is there, WAN is there, and then MAN is there, PAN is there, etc. Multiple type of networks are there. So, imagine it's like different languages. Okay, so a translator or a person who translates the languages, which helps us to understand different languages. Like that, a gateway which connects different type of networks to form a larger network. Okay, so it is capable of understanding different network architectures. Okay, so each and every network will have a different architecture. So a gateway is always capable of understanding this architectures and provide the connection or establishing the connection. Okay, so when two or more networks using different hardware and software have to be connected, some device is needed which can translate one network's language into another's. So a gateway is such a device. Next one we are going to see is a bridge. Okay, so a bridge connects multiple network segments at the data link layer. Okay, so it sends the data to the port that matches the MAC address. Okay, so the bridges do send broadcast to all the ports except the one on which the broadcast was received. Okay, it is also similar to a hub. Okay, a hub receives information and then transmits into all the ports, but a bridge do send the broadcast to all the ports except the one that which the broadcast was received. So the probability of bouncing back of data is eliminated here. Okay students, that was all the data devices or networking devices we are going to see, and then in the next class we will discuss another topic. Thanks for watching. Do learn all these devices very carefully.